Hello and welcome back to yet another special edition of the CW39 Houston's Digital Dive. I am Paige Hubbard, leading a very important conversation for the topic, which is Black History Month. We have a very special guest who's going to introduce himself and talk to us about what Black History Month means for him. Hello, welcome.
Hey, thank you so much for having me. I am Jeffrey L. Boney. I'm associate editor of the historic Houston Forward Times newspaper, and I am so excited to be here.
Thank you for being here. Before we get into, you know, the theme of the conversation, let's start off with, you know, what is the Forward Times for people who may not know?
So the Forward Times is a newspaper that was founded January 1960 by a gentleman named Julius P. Carter. He started off actually in the cigarette vending business, and he was an entrepreneur, and he was involved in so many social and entrepreneurial endeavors in the greater Houston area, but he had a passion to try to ensure that Black stories and Black people had a positive highlight in the community. And so he just didn't want to see all of these negative stories or these hard-hitting stories about things that Black people were going through. He felt that was important, but he also wanted to highlight the positive stories and photos of African Americans in the greater Houston area. So thus, he started the Forward Times newspaper, and you know, the rest is history. We've never missed a week of print in the history of our 64 years. Just celebrated 64 years in January. And so we're continuously moving forward as the largest and oldest independently published, consecutively published Black newspaper in the Southern region.
Big things.
We are.
Now, as a fellow journalist, I always say it's an incredible responsibility to hold this title and, so to speak, be the gatekeepers of information and decide how we filter it out back to the community. With that being said, how do you work to kind of, you know, eliminate the negative stereotypes that are sometimes placed on Black and brown communities?
Well, I mean, you know, you have to get facts and information and also understand the concept. I'll give you a prime example. Here recently, one of the mainstream publications published something about one of our current Houston City Councilwomen, Tiffany Thomas, and tried to say she held an unauthorized meeting as if she was somehow out of line for a committee meeting that she held. But she still, until a new chair was named, she still, in essence, the chair. And so because it seemed, based off of the reporting, that she was somehow doing something against the new mayor, you know, the story had to be told. And so she just wanted to make sure that the community's voice was heard by way of public hearings on some very important matters surrounding affordable housing in the city. So if not for our publication, and if not for being able to tell her story or her side of the story through our publication, you would just be left to, you know, kind of infer that maybe she did do something out of order or something against the current mayor's wishes. But that wasn't the case.
Context is super important.
Context is extremely important. Absolutely.
Now, switching gears here, you know, we invited you on to talk about Black History Month and the importance of having Black media. What does Black History Month mean to you?
Wow. You know, it means so much. You know, I'll start with one of the most important things. Who started Black History Month, Carter G. Woodson, who also happens to be my fraternity brother, Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Incorporated. But he started Black History Week, which morphed into Black History Month. And he did it in commemoration of two people, one being, of course, former President Abraham Lincoln, who, of course, was responsible for the Emancipation Proclamation, which emancipated slaves. Or formerly enslaved people of African descent. The other being Frederick Douglass, one of the greatest abolitionists and orators and authors of our time. And so, you know, when you think about the origins and those two important figures in history, Black history is American history. And so we have to incorporate all of the good, the bad, and the ugly parts of African Americans' engagement and involvement and participation in building this country. We are the original architects and builders of America. And so unless we're able to tell that story, and unless people know, then it's all going to be watered down, and people are going to assume that, you know, Black people had nothing to do with this country other than just being enslaved. And that's not the case.
We have to tell the full picture.
Got to tell the whole story.
As we wrap up here, is there anything else you would like to add just in terms of your role as a Black journalist, Black History Month, or anything, you know, all-encompassing of the thing?
I feel it's extremely important you know, and I'm very humbled to serve in this capacity. I understand the brevity and how important it is to be in this role, to tell stories and be, you know, someone who shares important content and information, not only to our community, but about our community to others. Just here recently this week, I wrote about the first black sheriff, not only in Fort Bend County and in Texas, but across the United States. The first black sheriff was right here out of the greater Houston area in Fort Bend County, Sheriff Walter Moses Burton. And so you think about how not, you know, that he was the first black elected after Reconstruction, or during Reconstruction, after the Emancipation Proclamation. And so you fast forward, not until 2020 did you have another African-American sheriff, Eric Fagan, in Fort Bend County become the sheriff. And so there's a lot of things that happened between Sheriff Burton and Sheriff Fagan that needs to be told. Those stories need to be highlighted. But you also have to not let people like Sheriff Burton be forgotten. He's a part of black history. It's not just Sheriff Fagan, who is now the current sheriff. It's the individual who was a trendsetter. He was the first black tax collector in Fort Bend County. He was a state senator in the state legislature in the state of Texas. Do people really know who Walter Moses Burton is? If they don't, then they can go to Forward Times and check that out, because we're the ones that are going to tell those types of stories.
Shameless plug. As absolutely. As we wrap up here, let's end with where people can find some of your publications and your social media handles.
Absolutely. You can go to www.forwardtimes.com. Again, that's www.forwardtimes.com. And you can always follow me at Real Talk Junkies, as RealTalkJunkies on Twitter, on Instagram. And of course, we have a Real Talk Junkies fan page on Facebook.
Good. That is a good spot to end it. Thank you so much for being here, and keep up the great work.
Thank you. I appreciate it.